Very quickly, I want to share with you on what I titled the God marriage. The God marriage. We have all kinds of marriage pattern in which a lot of families contract their marriages. The marriage we are looking at here is the pattern of marriage that God has designed for every Christian. As a Christian, you must go into marriage with a mindset that you are doing it the God way. Hallelujah. When it comes to marriage, you don't just jump into marriage because everybody is busy marrying on a Saturday morning. But going into the marriage with the blueprint that God has given matters. Some are just praying to go out. While those who are still single, they are praying to enter. Because when you interview some couples, they will tell you, "I am regretting my marriage." Some will tell you, if they had known, they wouldn't have entered. They would have preferred to be single than to be married. So that is why you that is anticipating to enter, you must enter the God kind of marriage. Some are busy preparing for their wedding. Wedding is not the ultimate. After wedding, all those that will come to attend the wedding ceremony, at the end of the day, they will all retire back to their various homes. Then the reality will dawn on the two couples. The husband and the wife will be left alone. The whole crowd will see they are just there for the celebration. But the marriage proper can only be sustained when they apply the God kind of principle to sustain it. Hallelujah. Let's take our first reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 2, 21 to 24. Genesis 2, 21 to 24. And the Lord God caused a deep sea to fall upon Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh instead thereof. Verse 22. And the rib which the Lord God had taken from man made he a woman and brought her unto the man. 23. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." Verse 24. And the last. "Therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh." May God bless his word. He will lead him and get rid of his word upon our lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Marriage is God's own initiative. Marriage is not what man initiates for himself. It is God's own idea. You can succeed marriage when you start it and run it in God's own way. You can only succeed marriage when you start it and run it in God's own way. Marriage is as old as creation. It's as old as creation. And it all started with Adam and Eve from the book of Genesis. We saw how Adam was on the face of the earth first without the presence of a woman. Woman was not there when Adam was living. Adam had everything to himself. God gave him grace to give name to everything he created. At the point, God saw that Adam was becoming lonely in the Garden of Eden. And he said, "It is good I give him a wife, a woman, for the purpose of procreation. The both of them will be fruitful, they will multiply, and expansion will be able to take place on the face of the earth." So eventually when the woman came, Adam could attest to it after that deep sleep that brought forth woman. Any man that will marry a good woman and make a good wife and handy must learn to observe that deep sleep. It means the man must sleep to a lot of things. Sleep and let go of distractions. Let go of things that will hinder the marriage. The man is expected to sleep and not to be noisy if looking for a wife. Hallelujah. And eventually when Adam saw the woman coming, he said, "This is the bone of my bone and the flesh of my flesh." And the Bible said he too became one, a husband and a wife. Let's look at Matthew 19, 3 to 9. Matthew 19, 3 to 9. Hallelujah. Matthew 19, 3 to 9. The Pharisees also came unto him, tempting him and saying unto him, "Is it lawful for a man to put away his wife for every cause?" Verse 4. And he answered and said unto them, "Have ye not read that he made them at the beginning, made them male and female?" 5. And said, "For this cause shall a man leave father and mother, and shall cleave to his wife, and they twain shall be one flesh." Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. There is difference between dating and courtship. Dating and courtship. Because we're talking about a sustaining relationship between the couple. If they are, like, we are looking at qualification, we are talking about qualification for the God marriage. When you talk about dating, the two of them, at that point, courtship has not come to exist. You are just meeting the man. The man is just meeting the woman. Hallelujah. Now, the first thing you want to know is this. Let's explore our potentials. Because courtship has not come to be established. Hallelujah. Now, I am beginning to sense a man coming around me. I am beginning to sense a woman coming around me. The first thing probably that will come to play in your mind, what is this person having? What is this person doing having? What is the potential of this person? What has this person have to give to the relationship? Is this person carrying a promising future, a promising destiny? Because you are not marrying them now. If you are going to marry, just in case, that relationship will end up in marriage. You are not going into it for the now. You are projecting yourself into the future. You are marrying the future. I know this man is not having money for now, but I see a future in this person. I see potentials in this man. I see potentials in this woman. Now these are the things you want to settle with, just in case you are going to say yes. Am I talking to somebody? You don't just see somebody just come to you, "I will marry you," you just accept. You must look at the potentials of this person. Oh, she's a graduate. He's a graduate. Okay. He's not a graduate, but I can see a skill in the hand of the man. Okay. I think with time, things will process, and this man will be concrete with this business. Okay, let me enter the relationship. Let me sustain it because of this potential around the person. But I know, if the Bible said, "So shall a man leave his father and his mother to look for his wife and cleave to her, the two shall become one, a husband and a wife." And the Bible said, "He that findeth a wife findeth a goodie, will obtain favor." If I marry him, favor will come into the home because I say, I'm going to say yes to him. These are the things you begin to calculate as I'm driving into it as part of the qualification that will drive you to sustain relationship. So that is dating. Dating is to explore the potentials you both carry. Things that will make you serious, just in case if somebody will propose. Hallelujah. Now, courtship is the next thing that will make you look, is the last one word that make you look into a marriage you want to enter. Am I talking to somebody? Say, "We are dating." Okay, if you tell me you are dating the man, you are simply saying that you are trying to do an understanding of the person. You are trying to do an understanding of the man or the woman. Let me understand her. Let me see what she has. That is dating. Say, "No, we don't have anything. It's just dating. We're just dating. Let me know before I will accept cutting with him." When you begin to cut, when you are in courtship, at that point you know you are talking marriage. Am I making sense? You are not beginning to talk marriage. And when you begin to talk marriage, it is not a nonsense for sex. It's not a nonsense for definement. And at that point, You are not looking at an environment where you can compromise. Maybe if you are to meet somewhere for discussion on how to drive a sustained relationship, you don't go to an hotel where there is room, where there is lunch. After reception, you just enter into room for sex. Hallelujah. You look for entry like pepperoni or climangelo. When you go and you discuss, when you discuss, you know, there is no room for accommodation. So if anybody sees you that you are in courtship with the opposite sex and you are in there, what comes into the mind of the man that saw you both will not be for immorality. I saw them in an environment they say so. But if somebody that sees you in an hotel reception, they will know that after this place, it will end in the room. Are you seeing it now? So these are the things you must look out for as a good quality when going into the God marriage, because we are talking about the God marriage. Then, number two qualification for the God marriage. By God's design, man should be head of the home. And as a woman going into a marriage relationship with a man, you should understand your role as a head meet. Because when the two of you come into talking terms, the man should know that I'm going to be the head of the home. The woman should know her role, that my role in that relationship is to help him meet some needs. So the woman must not be the end. If you are in a relationship where the woman is not trying to control, be at the control, end of the relationship, just so that the man has been relegated to the background and the woman is the one that is pioneering the relationship, that be forefront. Hallelujah. So as a woman, you must not try to be bossy in the relationship, that you are the boss. Because in a good Christian home, in a God kind of marriage, in your paragraph of marriage, Jesus is the head of the home. The next person that follows is a man, which is the man. Then the thing that follows is the woman. Then if it ends up in the marriage, the children now comes under the woman. Hallelujah. Comes under the woman. It begins to spread. So you must understand this as a Christian who is still single, that this is the qualification that makes up a good Christian home. And if a man is running away from responsibility, your own as a woman, my role is to help you meet some things to make you happy, succeed, but not to be the head of the home. So the man must know his role and make provision for the house. They must do things in agreement. Hallelujah. Let's look at Genesis 2:15-17. Then the Lord God took the man, not the woman. He took the man and put him in the garden of Eden to farm the land and to take care of it. Verse 16. The Lord God commanded the man, he said, you are free to eat from the tree in the garden. 17. But you must never eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, because when you eat from it, you will certainly die. Hallelujah. It was a man the Lord put in the area of productivity, as in to look for money and to take up the role. Know that you as a woman, you will not work. You will. Your God is to bring the support. The man must be the one, must be as the head of the home. Hallelujah. So, like that, block by block, a house is built. All depends on the source of the income of the man. Sometimes the woman may have a bigger job, but then she's a helpmate. They run the home by understanding. And she must know her role in the house. The past immediate president of Germany, Michelle, you know, she was a female president that ruled Germany for a very long time. When she was going into, when she was stepping down from office, they interviewed her. For all the years you've been president, for all the years you've been president, for all the years you've been president, how have you been coping with domestic things? How have you been coping with domestic things? How do you run it? Said, I am the one doing the cooking in their house. No, ask me. I cook for my husband. I do the laundry. I do the laundry. I do everything in the house the woman is supposed to do. For all the years, I have been president of children. You can see that she didn't allow the office to override her brain. To come back home and tell the husband, will I still rule Germany? I still come to the house and cook for you. She understood her role as a woman, that she's a helpmate. Amen, somebody. So most women, just a little opportunity that they have as advantage over the man, they want to make the man a rag in the home. They want to control the man. That is why sometimes God looks at their heart, they look at our heart to give us a blessing. If you're a woman, you are praying to be in control of your home, God, everything. Sometimes money is not coming. If you're not praying to, because God has seen your heart, that a little money will step on everybody's toes, including your husband. The man too, if you know you are in charge, and the little money that comes, you want to make your wife as a slave, the woman is slave in the house. It will make you want to secure money. It will make you want to secure money. So these are the things you must put into consideration. Then let's look at the other point. Qualification for the God marriage. Each partner to the marriage is the first. Is to first responsible to God before being responsible and responsive to each other. So as you are coming into marriage, you must be first be responsible to God as a man. You must first be responsible to God as a woman, a young lady, before you begin to respond to the man and be responsive to each other. In the little courtship you have, try to trust God for marriage. Most young girls don't come to church. Young boys don't come to church. My boyfriend said, make I cook for them. That's why I don't come to church. The way he's behaving, that is why I can't even go to church. The way she's behaving, that is why you see, for me to meet to church, I don't meet for the day. So when you are putting God first, before responding to each other, you succeed. But if you are responding to yourself first, before God, things will not go okay for that kind of relationship. Because if eventually marriage comes, it will be difficult. It will be difficult. Hallelujah. Genesis 3:8. In the cool of the evening, the man and his wife heard the Lord God walking around in the garden. So they hid from the Lord God among the trees in the garden. Verse 9. The Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you? Where are you? Where are you?" Praise the Lord. God called unto Adam. He didn't call Eve. He said, "Adam, where are you? Where are you?" Why? Because they must both, first of all, as a responsibility, respond to God first before themselves. So they were hiding instead of responding to God in that relationship. Any relationship that ends in marriage, that they are not responding to God, they will struggle in that marriage. They will struggle in that marriage. So please, you will not understand what I'm saying to you until the reality dawn on you. When the reality dawn on you, you will not know, say, "I wish I knew I would have been single first. To understand, who will understand me first before I enter?" But if you don't get these things before you enter, you struggle. A young lady contacted me from Zimbabwe and presented to me the man that she's going to marry. As I should pray, that they are having misunderstanding. So therefore I prayed. I didn't ask her to explain what happened. I said, "I'm going to pray." And what happened? When I prayed, did not give me insight. And I talked to her son. I said, "This man you want to marry, he has been married before." She said, "Yes." He had a child. She said, "Yes." And I said, "Look at it. This man has been into marriage before that dissolved. And want to marry to him. Experience has taught him a lot of lessons. You have not married before. Now, this man is beginning to entertain fear that every step it takes, you want to know everything it does at every time. And it's looking at it that you are trying to be domineering in the relationship." She said, "Papa, this is what we discussed 2 days ago. That all these things you are telling me, we talked about it when we sat down. And I said, the Lord said, you must bring your head down. Don't try to assert it. Don't try to prove as if you know too much. You must try and understand it too. Because any little step here, and where did you go? Where are you coming from? Let me see your phone. Who is calling you? Who is not calling you?" If you want to know things like that, allow this to play. Be prayerful. Because every man is afraid of a woman that will control him in the marriage. Hallelujah. So you must try your best to keep it balanced. I'm not telling you to be foolish in the marriage. You must strike a balance. Sometimes you might be more knowledgeable, more smart upstairs than the man. You must balance it. Don't make him feel as if you are too much, more than him. When you do over-sabi-sabi, the man will tell you, "I don't need over-sabi-sabi person. I want to. I need a woman I can play along with. Not that if I talk much, you talk 20. I talk 10, she will talk 50. If I want to measure up in talking 50, I say that she will talk 1,000. And before you know, the prayer of the man is full. Do you know that? The brain of a woman is bigger than that of the brain of a man. Bigger. Let me exaggerate it somehow. The brain of the man might contain just 2,000 words for a day. But the brain of a woman may contain 10,000 words per day. If the woman is not working at all, that would be more serious. She is at home as a full-time housewife without going outside. The whole day before the man returns from work, it will be 500 words inside. So 9,000, how many still remaining? 500 space is still in the brain. This is at evening when the man is coming back home. When the man returns back home, probably with the challenges he has seen outside, and immediately return, probably at the chair, just sit with the shoes still on, the leg intact, will just sleep. Joseph, the man will come, so you just came back and sleeping like this. After you take it, you give your strength to best friends outside. They are coming home looking and seeing you expressing you. Expressing you. Go and eat your food. Do you know what it takes me to go to a Swansea market? Or Tokyo market or Bono market to prepare this food? You came back and sleeping. The food is getting cold. Go and eat. Say, madam, don't sleep first. Let me just have some rest. Let me have some rest. Why won't you rest? After work, you will go to one or two places, then you return. I don't know where you go. Before, this is how the talk will begin to generate. In every man, there is a time they call a rewinding moment of every man. Rewinding moment. Now the man is back home. Just sit. Sit, cross the shoes. And he's just thinking, hey, the maker did not give me my money. Okay, this is how I went to draw my debts. And Solomon gave me a slap. We fought. No, I didn't tell my wife that I fought outside today. And okay, I'm going to finish the contract. Okay, by tomorrow, I will try my best to meet up. You see, look at bills coming. As a man is lying down like this, he's taking those things and sleep with just for a short while. He's trying to rewind and to empty his brain. Probably before he came, that 2,000 words to fill the brain. The brain is filled up until 1,090 words is inside the brain. It's not even 10 to make it 2,000. So anything you want to tell him, they will not be angry at that time. Are you hearing me now? He will be angry. So at that time, that is reminding, things are played. Things are played outside. It's reminding. You see, the woman will just come because her brain is still fresh. And the dustbin carrier came. And we tried to carry the dustbin. And someone said they will not contribute money to the compound. And the theater quarrel, and you see, and the man was okay, later. And you know, never people came to the broad pay, and you see, and see, relax, a woman don't wait first, wait a little bit, wait, I will attend to you. Then the next thing, when you go and eat, or go and shower, if it's that time, that will take back first before food. Say, just wait before the sleep come, and I see quarrel. Mr. Man, stand up. Where did you go to? I talked to you about those men. You shot me. Never be. You shot me out. Come and eat. You shot me out. Go and bath. You shot me out. You are still going to Jeanette's house. Look at all your strength. You've given your strength. Look at how tired you are looking. Look at your face. Look at your face. Say you will not. I'm not cheating at you. You will not understand. Do you know how I fought today?
you find, you, somebody thought, who is that? That is why I said relax. I'm trying to regain myself. Just wait. You don't know what I faced outside. As a foolish man, nail entered my hand. As a bricklayer, the shovel almost cut off my toe. You will not understand. Mother relax. You've been in this house since morning. You only went, that food I cook. You don't know knife cut my hand. Knife cut my hand. And you see, all these things like this are not supposed to generate quarrel. Just understand that your brain is better than his brain for that time. It's full. Let him evacuate. Probably after 30 minutes or 45 minutes, he's not going down. It will now reduce from 2,000 to 1,500. What were you saying about a maker? Say, okay, don't worry, I'll take you. Just give him time to evacuate. Just understand it. So when you are doing this relationship stuff, you must try to understand yourself to sustain it. Am I talking to somebody? To do what? To sustain it. God bless you. Are you enjoying it? I'm not saying the man, anytime you call, you tell the woman my brain is full. Full here. Don't use it as an excuse for a woman tired from here. Don't tire anywhere. Don't tire anywhere. Don't every time it happens. It happens. But if a woman tells you my brain is full, I'm very happy. Avoid her. I know what I'm telling you. Avoid her. When she strikes, it will not deadlier than when you strike as a man. Because she's going to vent all the anger at you. Praise the Lord. Okay. Then the next one. The man must recognize and accept the woman as his needed help. Bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. So as a man, you must recognize that she's the bone of your bone and flesh of your flesh. Without her, you can't contact favor from God. So you can't contact. To he that findeth a wife, findeth a good thing, and will obtain favor from God. They did not say, when the woman finds a man, she will obtain favor. She is favored herself. The woman, she is favored herself from God. Until you marry her, you will not still get that favor from God. There are things the man will never achieve in life. There are things the man will not achieve in life until he marries to a woman that carries this favor. The things you begin to go through. There are some relationships that you must just enter. It is in the marriage the man becomes a millionaire. But as a single man, he will just pour the worker for every year, food to achieve, work from soil to good without job. But the moment the wife comes to secure money, first a pot belly, a man that the tongue is very flat, take that space of the favor in his life, measuring neck. The man begins to develop weight. You can see how favor is rubbing off on the man. Does it mean the man was not eating before? He has been eating. Hallelujah. So please just recognize that she is a needed help for you. So you must not maltreat her in the relationship. Don't maltreat her in the relationship. Recognize that. Genesis 2:22-23. And the ring which the Lord God had taken from the man made he a woman and brought her unto the man. And Adam said, this is not bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. This is why he was respect the man to you. You as a woman, you were taken out of the man. So show respect. Then the next quality you must look at to secure a God marriage is this. There must be a decision for living and cleaving when it comes to marital destiny. You must be ready to forge ahead to fulfill divine purpose. You must be ready. That the man must leave. The woman must be ready to cleave to what has left his father's house and his mother's house. So, if the man is leaving his father and his mother, the woman must be ready to cleave to what left. When the Bible says the man must leave his father's house and his mother's house, it means that the man must, his mind must leave with him, must leave his father's house and his mother's house to cleave to his wife. Not that you are courting with a lady, but it is your mother that is controlling the courtship. Your father is controlling the relationship. When it happens like that and progresses into marriage, that marriage will be controlled by the parents of the man. Because the man is supposed to leave his father's house and his mother's house with his mind, everything, and invest it on the life of the woman. And not that you are married, you are taking instruction from your mother. Come now, bomboy. The man becomes a bomboy in the marriage. Because at the age of 75, Abraham was still under the tutelage of his mother. When God called him out, he has married with Sarai in the house. When God called him out, he said, no, you have a good heart. I want to bring you out of your father's house and your mother's house. So kindred, so you can have a mind of your own. Otherwise, you remain poor. Look at marriages that are being controlled by parents. They don't do much in life. They don't do much in that relationship. Hallelujah. It was when Adam, it was when Abraham left and separated totally that he met riches. He was all rich in gold, in silver, and in cattle until he separated from his father's house and his mother's house. So don't tempt a man. Try to tempt him to know when you are taking him, your family is around in his strength. Eventually, when you enter into the courtship, you must try to find out if he is actually leaving his father's house and his mother's house to establish a relationship with you. Find out those things, otherwise you will suffer in that relationship. When there is little quarrel, mama, my wife, she's misbehaving, this family, you come and talk to her. The next thing you will see, the boy's father in your home. Carry one big bag, no one go. 3 months, still there. 1 year, still there in your house. How will you cope? You can't cope. You cook this food, you tell you. Is this what you cook for my son to eat? Too much pepper. Pepper. Look at those food, water everywhere. My son needs to give you good money. Look at the kind of food we are cooking. My son asked to buy chicken. He went and buy willy-willy there. Say, mama, is this not chicken? Is this not chicken I smell inside this thing? Did my son give you money to buy your family? Chicken. Oh, you are going to buy the fruit. Where is the body? Where is the lab? My son is suffering. With all this money, he's working hard in the city to buy. To get. You are just using the money in your hand. No wonder you have plenty bags. Your shoes are many. Your clothes are different. My son is not just wearing a front to work and come back. When you are Sunday, my son will dress well. But look at you, how you are dressing well. So you have bone streets. You have a human hair. What do you do? Look at me. In my days, I don't get things like this. You can't enjoy that kind of food. You can't. Vice versa. Hallelujah. As a man or a woman who wants to marry, you must be ready to make the Holy Bible a standard for your life. This will help you both not to listen to the devil
and cause you distractions in your relationship. The Bible must be a standard for that relationship. If you are praying and the man is complaining in courtship that you pray too much, run for your dear life, ministry. You must run, because that one, by the time you get married, he will tell you not to go to church. He will tell you. Because anybody who's not going to church must pay allegiance to his master one day. His master is Satan. He will pay homage one day to Satan. Say, we have Islam. Come to be a church. Come and sit down in their house. Whose church? Am I not making money even without church? You see, some men tell you, will be telling the woman, church, no church, I am making money. What do you want? Whose church? Are you going to church to pray for God to give you money? The money has given it to me. Come and sit down in their house. So you must try to check out these things. Hallelujah. Joshua 1:8 said, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. You will not have good success if the word of God is not a standard for that relationship. Make it a standard. Marriage is not just for the son of couple, but for the enforcement of the divine mandate of fruitfulness, multiplication, replenishment, subduing the earth, and exercising total dominion on earth as couple, not as you trying to dominate the woman, enslave her, or trying to dominate the man and enslave him. Hallelujah. Marriage is designed for one godly man and one godly woman that will come together as husband and a wife. Genesis 1:27, God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he male and female, created he them. Hallelujah. So God did not create a man and a woman not to come into the relationship. He created them for relationship, for procreation, for replenishment. So he did not create them that the man should marry to a man, the woman should marry to a woman. Like we see these days, lesbianism and homosexuality. Even in the body of Christ, two girls are befriending themselves, having sex with themselves. You see men befriending themselves. They don't care for women, but they care for themselves. It is not Adam for Adam. It is Adam and Eve. So don't enter into a relationship that will be for Adam and Adam, or Eve for Eve. Two female touching themselves. If your father and your mother did that kind of life, you wouldn't have been breathing now. There is no way you come to earth. Hallelujah. Then lastly, what will qualify you? I've given you the qualities, right? I will still have some good qualities. You must love God and put Him first before anything you do in life. You must accept Jesus Christ and make Him your Lord and your personal Savior. The two of you must be born again. You can't marry an unbeliever. One day is going to pay dues to his master Satan. He can sacrifice you. When it's an awkward man, you are entering because of the money you are seeing. What if you use it to donate in his kingdom? Vice versa. So you are entering because the woman is rich. You know, you make the woman that awkward woman can donate you as the next person she wants to donate in a society. So you must look at it, my brother, you want to marry me, you come to church, let's go to church for prayers. Next week's day, you are cutting, you don't have in the week, You don't have days to fast, days to pray together. Say, look, you must fast. We must fast Monday. Declare as our fasting day. Whether you are in Sokoto and in Jamaica, let us fast. Let's put this thing into focus to not have distraction. There will be no room. You can't be cutting and you are sleeping in one house. One day you pray and before you know you are laying down your trouser or praying down the gun. In the bit of prayers. So you must check out these things. Hallelujah. You must not defy the prayer. You must be family oriented. You must have respect for family. Some persons don't have respect for families. You must marry to a man who respects family. When you are in courtship and does not respect his own family, how will he respect you when you are married? Talk to his mother anyhow. Talk to his father anyhow. Talk to his brothers anyhow. Fight them and block them. You are expecting him to be a good man, a good husband in that marriage. You want to end up. One day we'll begin to fight you too. The same thing applicable for the woman too. You must have a vision for your future and chase your vision with passion. The future you fail to see, you can't future in it. As you are planning life together, you must plan to see a good future ahead of you. If you don't see anything good ahead of you, you will not make up a good home tomorrow. You must be ready to be supportive and encouraging at all times. Don't live a life of self-centered life. Only you. Buy good. A man who does buy good for himself alone is not a good sign when you are caught in. No, it's not a good sign. Look himself more than you. It's not a good sign. Let him spread his hands except he's not happy. You must be honest. You married to a man, a woman, you are courting. And somehow, there is food around, she's hiding it. So there is no food, though. There is nothing. If the person is hiding things from you, is a red flag. It's a red flag that something is fishy. You must be honest and genuine. Live a credible life. To be credible is to be known for holiness, righteousness, and integrity. If you are competent without credibility, you will still not be a good person. If you are skillful and not carry holiness, you don't carry integrity and righteousness, you will see damage at the good at work and bad at home. So you must be good at home and good at work. Hallelujah. And give us two scriptures, we are done. John 27:4-10. John 27:4-10. My lips shall not speak wickedness, nor my tongue utter deceit. You see, many persons in their relationship, they talk wickedness. They challenge themselves. I will kill you. I will deal with you. You use harsh words on each other while you are watching. Then when you now marry, what will happen? Your boyfriend will ask you. We sit on social media where the man is sleeping. She checked before and saw text message. Suspecting the man dating outside. The man, the young lady carried a knife and cut off his manhood while he was sleeping. Cut it off. So while he was sleeping, take knife. They're shooting on him. You see, begin to plan revenge. So if you don't secure the God kind of relationship, you might probably end up in a bad marriage. You will end up going for prayer meeting for deliverance or for deliverance until one person will pack off. One person drop dead. So carry your partner along. Come with that person to church. Carry yourselves along within the church environment so it will be fine. Verse 6.
But verse 5, God forbid that I should justify you. Till I die, I will not remove my integrity from me. Look at Job saying, my righteousness I hold fast. I will not let it go. My heart shall not reproach me so long as I live. Verse 9, then said his wife unto him, do thou still retain thy integrity? God's gonna die. The wife of Job is telling him, cause God and do all die. Why are you respecting this God? Look at your affliction all over your body. Cause him and die. Hallelujah. But he said to her, Job said to his wife, thou speakest as one of the foolish women speaketh. What? Shall we receive good at the hand of God and shall not receive evil? In all this did not Job sin with his lips. Small challenge to the next level. You must understand. Hallelujah. Then the last scripture concerning the psalmist, Psalm 78:72. 78:72. So he fed them according to the integrity of his heart, and guided them by the skillfulness of his hand. David had credibility, integrity of his heart. David had competence, skillfulness of heart. David fed them according to the integrity of his heart, guided them according to the skillfulness of his hand. Let your heart carry integrity. As long as your heart knows how to do the job, let there be integrity inside of you, so that everything will be fine. Hallelujah. And it shall be well with you in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you, the Lord will give you a sweet home. We give you a good marriage. We give you a good man, a good woman, in the name of Jesus Christ. And be ready. The Lord shall anoint you with money, so that you will contact sweetness in the relationship and go to enter. But if you are into a relationship that does not respect God, that does not acknowledge church, if you have that kind of relationship, beloved, you will not make up a good name if you marry that kind of person. From the foundation, you can be able to know the strength of the house. Every structure is determined by the foundation. So you must have build a good foundation for a better relationship, marital relationship tomorrow. And I pray that you will succeed. But if there is any relationship you are into that will destroy it tomorrow, it is better you break it now than broken marriage. Broken courtship is better than broken marriage. If you break it now, it will be better that you are breaking your marriage tomorrow and you are regretting. You will not regret. God will not give you a home that will make you regret. He will give you a home that you are going to celebrate. Marriage is not meant to be endured. It is meant to be enjoyed. We want to endure marriage here. You want to endure marriage, God forbid. You want to endure marriage, don't endure marriage. Enjoy marriage. Endure. When I say endure, you did answer. You must enjoy it. You must enjoy it. In Jesus' name. Let's pray on our feet.